jamming out over here. Still kind of loud. So it's gonna be like 28 decibels. No, there we go. Sorry, I'm trying to. Conrad wanted me to stream, so I was gonna do a stream. I'm surprised he's not in here yet, fucking dickhead. I should just send him a message on Skype. So, right now, I'm trying to figure out how to view the chat, because I only have one computer screen, and I was gonna play a game while I wait for some people to show up. And if I'm playing a game, I can't see the chat. So, last night when I streamed, I had my laptop set up to me, but that was kind of a mess. I don't really want to do that again. Nope, will not let me. Well, that sucks. So I can view the chat on my tablet, but it's really fucking tiny. Oh, hey, there's Conrad. Yeah, I'm in Japan now. That's the only way I could be fucking doing this. It's not happening in China. I wish there's a fucking way to. So I was looking it up, and it says that the app supports live chat viewing, but I can't get the app to work on my fucking tablet. So I just opened the chat up in my browser on my tablet, but it's so fucking small. Like, I have to fucking lean into my tablet to fucking read this shit. Oh, hey, if I turn it sideways. Oh, that makes it. God, I'm an idiot. That makes it so much better. Okay. Just do it like that then. Oh, that is just so much more legible. Alright, so the one thing I do want to do is set my screen not to go to sleep. Display. Sleep. Okay, there is no turn off display sleep, there's only set it to 30 minutes. Okay. That's cool. It's easy and difficult. Pretty much, if you're white, you're pretty much guaranteed an interview. But most of the schools here don't want to sponsor a working visa if you live, outside of Japan. What the fuck, Conrad? You asked me to do this and you leave? What a fucking dickhead. Please, Nolan, stream right now! Oh wait, hang on, I'm not gonna be here. Well, that's fine. I was gonna play some Overwatch while I waited for more people to show up anyways. Where is game capture? There we go. I feel like the chat window is pretty big. Let me fix that. Make that a little bit smaller. There we go. That's probably tolerable. Not the worst in the world. I feel like the game volume might be loud. So here I go fucking with audio settings again. Master volume. There we go.
is, you know, it's easy to find a job. There's places that are always hiring just all the time. But, being able to find a place that is also willing to sponsor your visa.
I play to win.
Yeah, that's... that one's kind of difficult. Okay, did a match get found, or did the game just decide to lock up? What is happening here? Okay. Sure. Yeah, excuse me. It's allergy season, so. I'm not trying to make disgusting noises into the microphone. Not with the job. At least not where I'm. Not working. For legal reasons, I can't say a lot. But for the place that I would be working, it's an immersive environment, meaning they do not allow speaking Japanese inside the school. It is entirely everything. Everyone must speak English.
Arriving at watch point,
so, as far as working goes, no. In fact, what a lot of teachers have a problem with is that they're trying to learn Japanese, but they never get a chance to practice it because they're working.
Prepare to attack. Select your hero.
Of course, most of the teachers have lived here in Japan for quite a while, actually. So they're all pretty... they're all pretty skilled in Japanese. Since I have not been living here for years and years, not knowing it kinda sucks as far as, you know, just wanting to do common things, you know, can't really talk to people very well. But there's a lot more people, at least in Osaka, that know some English. Not to mention Japanese itself has, you know, they've added so many, they've Japanified so many English words that you might not even realize that you're speaking Japanese. It depends, I don't know, the teachers' pays have actually been decreasing here in Japan. However, the place that I'm not working at, their pay is quite a bit better than most. I'm not saying it's excellent. It's not like I want to be a rich motherfucker, but it's more than enough to live comfortably. That is, working full time. Plus, you know, if you have a kid, you get discount on tuition. That probably doesn't mean anything to you, but it does to the teachers, because most of them are married and have kids. I don't want to see the kill cam. I know I did poorly.
I'm not a good loser.
I should mention though, sorry, I got really into the game there. I should mention that right now I'm not getting paid excellently at all. Because I'm not working for the school, remember? No. In China, yes, but in Japan, no. All the teachers at the school that I'm at are treated really well. Most of the other teachers have talked about the previous jobs, and they've never said that they were mistreated, but they did say that they usually had the schools usually had pretty high expectations of them. So, fuck you. I mean, so, for an example here, I mean, fucking Japanese people are some of the nicest fucking people ever. So for a personal example, now this isn't at the school that I don't work for. This is just wandering the streets. You know, I went to an arcade, and they had a bunch of those claw games there. And there was a Cocoa figure, and we all know how much I love Cocoa. So I wanted to see if I couldn't win it. It was pretty close to being won already, so I decided I'd give it an attempt. And before actually trying to win it, I decided to watch some guys who were pretty pro at winning the claw games. Wait, is this an actual match? Oh, okay. I thought that was just a skirmish. Okay, this is a skirmish. So after watching them win a few things, I decided I'd try my own. You know, I'd try winning on my own. And I went and tried it. I didn't make it. I got kind of close, but I didn't win it. The guys saw me trying to win the figure, and so they came over and they decided to make all of the moves necessary, except for the very last move to winning the figure. And then when there was just one move left to win the figure, they handed the controls over to me and let me make the last move to win the figure. I mean, this is just one example, but I've had overall really positive experiences with just most of the Japanese people in general. That being said, there's obviously not everyone is the same, so not every Japanese person here is as kind and considerate, but in general, they all seem pretty nice. It's the Chinese people who have no fucking consideration for anyone. I'm trying not to sound like a fucking racist bastard, but I just... Don't you lie to me, D.Va. You're not healed up. Negative. Shit's expensive here. Honestly, something that did surprise me is that there is still a pretty strong negative vibe, negative stigmatism towards anime watchers, even though they're far more predominant in Japan than, you know, in America. But those that don't watch anime still have some sort of negative stigma towards anime watchers. just like people in America. That actually surprised me a little bit. Man, this is a long-ass fucking...
Fully operational.
There. I have to fucking bitch about it first before finally fucking find a game. Them to pick their heroes first, because chances are, yep. I never get to play D.Va in a real match. I'll just play Murky.
I'll be watching over you.
As mentioned by some people, there's very few people who go to Japan and have sort of a moderate experience. There are those that come here and tend to just hate the place, and then there are those that come here and just fucking love Japan. Yes and no, it depends on where you're from. If you're from America, then kind of yes. If you don't have a degree, then you can have an equivalent amount of experience in the field that you're working in. If you have... Oh, shit. So it's 3 years experience. They want 3 years experience if you're an American. This is not a Japan thing, necessarily, why they don't want to give Americans an easier time. It's America's fucking foreign policy that makes it difficult for Americans. There is such thing as a working holiday visa. Basically, it is a one-year-long valid working visa. It is very easy and quick to get. Most countries offer a working holiday visa. However, America does not offer the working holiday visa to any country. And so because they don't offer it to any country, the country doesn't return the favor. I'm gonna die. Any degree. They don't want it. Japan just wants to make sure they're not bringing fucking shitlord scumbags into their country. So the degree just kind of proves that you aren't a shitlord scumbag.
I could use some assistance.
Getting distracted. Sorry. Fuck me. So there's another thing. This is another option I had to look into. Is there is such thing as a life experience degree, which is technically speaking just a scam. However, basically what it is they charge you an exorbitant fee. Oh, that was stupid. They charge you an exorbitant fee and we'll look at your resume and then issue a degree based on your resume. And you can pick whether you want that degree to be a bachelor's, a doctorate, or, you know, whatever. Of course, depending on how nice the degree is, how high-tiered the degree is, the more it costs. Like, a doctorate will cost you, like, $1,000, while a bachelor's will cost you, like, $400. So I looked into that option. Now, it doesn't work for any job that's looking... Like, you're not gonna cheat any fucking legit business that's looking for a specific degree. However, the government, who doesn't really care what degree you have or where it came from, so long as you have a degree, it'll work. So I've heard, at least. So I looked into that option. I did not do it, though. I went with a different option as an American. Which, again, for legal reasons, I really can't talk about. I really wish this fucking... What in the shit? Oh my god. Fuck me. Anyways, as I was saying, if you're not American, you have a lot of options. But if you are an American, because America doesn't offer the working holiday visa to any countries, no countries offer the working holiday visa in return. So yeah. That's just America's shitty foreign policy there. You are a tank. You are supposed to go in and push. Please push. I've got you in my sights. I've got you in my sights. It's close. It's a little bit better. Not much better, though. And it depends on the school. And also, it depends on where you are. Osaka actually usually has pretty... has lower pay because it's cheaper to live here. Tokyo, because it's a really fucking expensive city, tends to have higher pay because it's an expensive city. Why did I walk in here? This was a dumb choice. I'm gonna take care of this fucking diva because I think she understands what the fuck it means to be a tank. Join me if you win. Healing stream engaged. Jello is here. Suo. Yeah. Wonders of modern medicine. Probably. The other option... Yeah, I had mentioned... I think I already said this. I'm so distracted with playing the game that I don't remember what I've said. Pretty sure I already said this, but if I didn't, your second option is to have at least 3 years experience in the field, and you'd have to prove it by having letters from your previous employers. Well, I played like ass. That match. I'll play one more game, and then we'll do the usual just music and talking. Because I think with Jello and Conrad here, and with Grass already being here, I think that's enough for a pretty regular... conversation.
I need healing.
I've heard them say need a healer or whatever. Not need healing, but okay, or that works. Fucking whatever.
Traveling to Hanamura.
I don't know why I'm taking this seriously at all. This is just a skirmish. It's going to be huge! Conrad, what's huge? Your video's probably fucking stupid and you should not publish it. God damn it. God damn it. I really feel like for a skirmish game, there should not be spawn times. Well, fuck you, fucking Widowmaker. Fuck you, I kill. That was awful. Ah, what the shit?
Bad guys.
Oh no! Someone broke the claw game! Fighters of the Storm. I get it. I get it. Like Heroes of the Storm, but it's Fighters of the Storm. You fucking get it? Oh, hey, we found a game.
Ilios.
By the way, Conrad, I don't know how long I'm going to be streaming. I have my first Japanese-English exchange lesson, as it's called. Which has been difficult to find, by the way. You would think... Living in the country, select your hero. You'd think living in a country where Japanese is spoken by everyone, you'd think it'd be easy to find a motherfucking person who'd be willing to do an exchange lesson where, you know, you teach them a little English, they teach you a little Japanese. Yeah, but no, it's taken me forever to find this, but today I finally got it set up and I have a feeling... Yeah, it's mostly just gonna be me doing English, and there's not gonna be a lot of Japanese, but... A moment to enjoy some peace and it's the first lesson, so maybe next time we'll do more Japanese and less English.
Hi!
So, my point of saying that is that I gotta get ready, because it's, you can actually see the clock on my game, top right corner. Unless you're streaming in shit quality, then you can't see the clock. It's 11:40 a.m., so. Oh, what the shit? So I had a little Cocoa zipper pull that I had on my jacket. You weren't in the stream when I was talking to Grass about this. There's still a negative stigma towards anime watchers here in Japan. So I really don't like bringing up my anime watching while I'm at school. Just because they saw my Cocoa figure and was like, or my Cocoa zipper, and they were like, "Do you like girls?" And I was like, yeah? They're like, "Do you really like girls?" Like, whoa, 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 what are you implying? So yeah, I don't really like to talk about that at school. However, not my boss, because I don't work at school. She's fascinated by it. She's curious, I guess I'd say. There's a big cosplay event happening in Denden Town, which is like Osaka's Akihabara, and it's on Sunday, and I told her that I was gonna go, so she was like, "What character are you gonna cosplay?" I'm like, "Oh, no, I'm not cosplaying." She's like, "Well, what character would you cosplay?" And I was like, "I'll cosplay Dante from DMC." So she googled Dante. Sorry. Grass, yes, I do. But not all the teachers work Saturdays. This school is... Actually, I don't work. I'm sorry. I don't work. If I worked for the school, yes, I would. Yes, I would work on Saturdays, but most teachers don't work on Saturdays, because Saturdays at the school is special.
Affirmative.
They're special, so, yeah, not as many students show up on Saturdays. Shit! No, not at all. They're like completely fucking opposite. Like, Japan and China are like the most opposite fucking countries ever. China has like fucking zero sanitation standards. No one in China gives a fuck about you. They have no consideration for other people. And meanwhile in Japan, you know, nearly everyone is considerate.
Best round one.
Nearly everyone is considerate, and they have retardedly high sanitation standards here. Like, fucking higher sanitation standards than America. Anytime you buy any food from any place, you always get a wet wipe. Most restaurants, when you sit down, they give you a warm hot towel to wipe your hands before you eat. All the bathrooms are so fucking clean. Even like busy convenience stores still have like retardedly clean bathrooms. You could probably eat off the floor in the bathrooms, although I would not recommend it, but you get my point. Maybe a few. We're not for sure, but one of the kids that goes to the school, we think that maybe her dad might be part of the Yakuza. Simply because he looks the part, right? That's really the only thing we're going on. He just looks the part, and that's really it. But, you know. Oh, shit. Fuck. I haven't lost my pinky yet. Yakuza mostly just harass small businesses. I didn't finish what I was saying about the parent. Oh my god, where the fuck is my team? Holy nuts.
My ultimate is ready.
My ultimate is ready.
This was fucking awful. What the shit? Okay, even if they were all wiped out, and I was the only one left standing, how come I was there for like fucking 15 seconds? Just by myself.
Heroes never die.
So, the parent, he has like slick back hair, he always wears a suit, and he never fucking smiles, right? He's like the epitome of Yakuza. I think we lost this round, he definitely did. I don't know why I'm putting up a barrier against him. He's melee.
Round two, loss.
Yeah, lost this round.
Scores 1-1.
Game on.
wasted upon the soul.
Group up with me. Group up. Now we're talking. Defense matrix activated.
His daughter is adorable, though. It makes me laugh. Like, anytime you just, like, come up to her and surprise her, or, just, like, poke her or something, she's always like, hey! I don't know. I think it's adorable. It's funny.
Group up with me!
Where the fuck is my team? What the shit is this?
Diva re-engaging.
I'm on the objective. Rally to my position.
I haven't seen that. I don't have a katana yet, and I haven't seen that many samurai just eating roadside ramen noodle stands. I have seen kimono girls, though.
Time to raise my APS. Don't worry, I got it. Boosters engaged.
Oh, shut up. I think I'm already on the list. I know you guys want to kill, but seriously, this is the objective. Let's stay here. Defend the fucking objective, dickheads. Don't just go off killing shit.
Justice reigns from above.
I'm too young to die.
Kind of. But also, apparently once you marry the woman, I've heard this from like all the teachers, like the romance ends. It stops outright, and they will just outright tell you, like, yo, if you want to go get some, just go hire a prostitute. Like, this is done. I have a child. You have a job. That's all I need. Why doesn't my team help push? Awesome. My ultimate is ready. Now let's just not die.
Fully operational.
Using the KO. Yeah.
Oh my god, that was fucking glorious. Oh, but it didn't fucking win it! Get in there! Fucking stop it! God damn it! Come on! dickheads, come help! Capture. Where's the healer? Where's the healer? Where's the healer? Not here. Fuck! Oh my god, we are so close. Come on. Come on. Come on! No, come on! No, don't let them capture the point, dickhead! Go in there! Just go in there! Don't worry about killing, motherfucker! Yes!
Play of the game.
How and or where did I learn English? From being an American? From growing up in America? Why am I not in the fucking four here? Fuck you guys. I feel like I fucking... I wouldn't say carried because I'm a tank. I can't fucking kill anything. I don't do damage. But still... Yeah, like I said, that would be the last game, and then I'll just talk. I am curious, yeah. Let me see that. I want to see if it has the fucking highlight for that. Fucking triple kill, man. No. No. Aw, come on, but that was so fucking cool. Fucking bullshit. Oh my god, grass. This fucking tells you how long I've already been in Japan. I saw Miami, and I fucking read that as Miami. That's actually the name of one of our students, Miami. I think that's probably why I misread that, because I'm used to seeing my student's name, Miami. Alright, let's do the usual. Let's put some music on and just chat. There we go. So I guess I can close out of the chat on my tablet now. I don't need that open. That last game was long. I wish I could have saved that. I guess I was kind of recording it, wasn't I? That last match was good. Fuck you if you think otherwise. I know neither of you are probably gamers because you're on my channel, but... Oh, come on, you know that got pretty intense there at the end. So anyways, I'm Conrad Jello. I guess you're Jello, you might still be here. I don't know, I haven't seen you come up in the chat in a little bit, Jello, but I moved since not last time, I had streamed last night, but the time before that, the first Nihon International Nihon Netcast
That happened at my at a different apartment. I have since moved to a place that now has no data cap on the internet, and faster internet too. So that's why I've been streaming more. Yay!
Well, thank you, Conrad. Could you even watch it? Normally, you just watch the chat and listen to me talk.
Math assignments. Oh boy. I have my Japanese assignment here.
Me? Not really. There was a time when I used to have interest in cars, but that died quickly after having like a $4,000 repair bill for a $4,000 car. Made that $4,000 car into putting down $8,000 for this fucking car. And even after all the repairs, it was still only worth $4,000. I was like, yep, this is not my hobby. This is expensive and stupid. So now my hobbies are music and YouTube and writing. Which that reminds me. I guess while I'm streaming, I can do this. We can do a desktop capture if I want. Oops, I don't want to rename that. I'm going to remove that. And remove that. And we will add monitor capture. Okay, but I want to move that down. Position, move. Order, move down. Down. Okay, here we go. So I'll work on this. His hobbies. I don't have a car here because I don't have a driver's license here. There's a lot of people here who have cars. I don't think I would ever get one, honestly, just because since I live in Osaka, where I don't work, but I will be working. Where I just moved to is actually really convenient. I actually will be working at two different schools. They're both owned by the same company, right? It's just two different locations. Oh shit, where is it? Hang on, I gotta turn off desktop capture for a second. Oh, that's window capture there. But one takes a different train line. Like, there's the municipal subway, and then there's the other privately owned train lines, like the Hanshin line, Hankyu line, and JR line. And I actually have to take the JR line to get to the second school location. And to get there, I need to take the JR line to get to the second location. So it's actually really convenient where I moved, because it's like 30 minutes either by the municipal subway to get to the first school location, or 30 minutes by the JR line to get to the second school location. So, I don't know. To me, it makes more sense, I don't know, to not worry about having a car. See you later, turtle. First I want to go here.
that in there. Do with it. Now it's here somewhere. Is it references? No. See, oh, there it is. Fucking party. We should be shorter. So, anyways. Yeah, how's it going, guys? I don't want to get too distracted here. Here's what I'm going to do. Let's move this like this. You don't want to snap, do you? So, I don't need to constantly switch back and forth. I can see both. Everything. So anyways, you know, there's some people who, as I was saying, there's a lot of people here who actually drive. I feel like making him smaller was kind of stupid. For myself, mostly, yeah. I mean, like, I have this one here. I have this one open so I can have, like, a guide. So, like, where's my marquee? I'm writing in the chat. There we go. Marquee. Use this one instead. Own layer. There we go. You can't see anything. Oh, you're right. Yep, that's my bad. I must have accidentally pressed one of the scene switch buttons. I have pot keys to switch to different scenes. I must have switched to one of the scenes that has nothing on it right now. Oops, I need this one. Yeah, this is the first one. I have them unlisted, they still exist though. So obviously March 11th I streamed the first one, and then last night I streamed the second one. But because Conrad's a whiny little baby who gets drunk, who's like, "Oh, please stream again today." And he wasn't like that. I'm joking. So now I need to get the text lined up. No, text. I swear. It shouldn't be so small like that. Why is it small? Sand. I guess that's the only one that I have. So I guess I'll just make it bigger. You don't recognize Conrad? Conrad's always here. So now, oh, thanks. So nice. Feel like the dark green is too saturated. I need to turn that down. As you can see, I'm making a fucking background. Let's extend it to there. Yeah, that looks a little bit better to me. Yeah, and sorry that I've been streaming more on YouTube. It's just, it's so much easier. I really don't like the Twitch player that much.
Jello likes it when I yell at him, though. True story. It's the only reason why he's friends with me is because he just loves hearing me just call him a fucking faggot all the time. What a great friendship we have.
It bothers me that the heads are in a different place. I should fix that. You're funny. Did I ever get through those recommendations? Well, let's take a look here. Oh, long game folder. I did actually get through Chuni. Someone recommended that. I think that was you, Lollers, who recommended... It was either Jello or Lollers who recommended Chuni, and whoever it was, thank you. That was a fucking great anime. I did not get through Madoka Fucklords. Sorry about that. Did not get through Shinsekai Yori. Did not get through Yahari Ore no Seishun Love Kome wa Mach. Good God. Yeah, I've heard, but I went ahead and got the second season. I downloaded that shortly after I finished the first season because I just love the first season so much. I haven't watched the second season yet, though. So that first head. This one? No. This one. Yeah, that one is too high up. It's nearly clipping off the page. And this head is nearly clipping off the page as well. So now... Oops. I turned both of them off. I feel like the Everstream logo is not matched up. No, this Everstream logo looks way more fucking sharp than this one. And that's because I'm pretty sure... The first season is only 12 episodes, retard. Like, this fucking Everstream right here is so fucking sharp, and this one is just ever so slightly soft around the edge. And I'm pretty fucking sure that's because I had to shrink... the fucking logo and not stretch it. So I... Where the fuck is it? So what size is this? Oh, I know what it is. Wait, is it? Huh? Wait a minute. Let's go here. This should be 1920 by 1080, right? No. I think Valentina made this a larger size. Well then. Huh? What? Are you talking here? Talking about this? I mean, these are fucking pictures from years ago. Let's see. I got 2015, that's not right. I don't know. There's me, actually. You can see my face. That was from years ago. That was back when I lived in... I don't know. Who would? And I have other silly pictures here, too. Like this. Revenge! The Master Chef. Anyways, oops. A face reveal from years ago. It's not really my face anymore. Wait, is that... I thought the they've changed it so that you that way you can turn that off now, and I thought it was turned off. Hang on, let me go to. Hang on, I'm gonna turn off the screen capture for a second. Nope, that's the wrong one. I always do that. Oh, I know, it's under advanced settings. Comments. No. Yeah, actually I have Lawler's I have revealed my face on my second channel. Let me leave the page. I'll turn window capture back on. Or monitor capture, excuse me. Random anxiety. That's cool. Is it the music? Is the music pumping you up too much? You should be able to post links, right? How did you make your chat dark, by the way? Shame on you. This is Sawa's. I don't know. Let's see. Let's practice my hiragana. Yep, I only recognize two characters here, so never mind. Can't read it in Romanji for you. Sorry about that. But this, it's okay. You're gonna have better results if you just Google the album code. I had to look up the album code last night. So if you Google Sawa-570, that's the album code, it'll come up. It'll come up better than if you just Google the name, actually, because it's apparently a pretty small band, which is weird, because they were doing this promotion when I bought the album where you get a picture of Sawa herself, and you also get a little fucking folder, I guess, to put it in. They like these folder things. It's not the first time I've gotten one of these folders, like art folder. I don't know. I think they're stupid. Pung. What did I call it? Well. Okay. That chat delay. I haven't said, it should be, and the chat delay is probably even worse. I don't download my music because finding fucking Japanese music on when you're searching in English is like nigh on impossible. I actually went to, there's a big record store here in Japan called Tower Records, and I just went there, and literally, like, I just went
I went to go pick up some specific music, and they didn't have the specific song I was looking for. The specific album I was looking for. So I just decided, well, let me go browse around and see what they have, and I just picked up two albums just based on their cover art alone and nothing else. And they, both of them just so happened to be pretty good. In fact, I see the picture of it. So here's my shopping that I did that day, right here. So Sawa is here, and then here's Esno. I can put Esno. I think Esno is my favorite of the two that I bought. I do like Sawa, though. Let's go to Esno, since we've listened through all of Sawa now. Photoshop files. Everstream. Oh, you know what? Actually, no. I don't like doing this, because sometimes... sometimes my external hard drive randomly disconnects for a second and it'll make my background go black. So I like moving. Even though I have the wallpaper here, I like moving it onto my local hard drive. So that way. So now there should be two selected. As far as I'm aware, no. And I don't know who Akiko Yano is, either. This seems alright. Is that Tararisa? Tararisa? Where's my fucking hiragana sheet? Wait, don't fucking chat for just a second. I need to pull out my hiragana sheet so I can fucking read what the fuck you sent me. So I was right about da, at least. Yep, ta da re. That kind of looks like re, but it also might be e. I think that's e. That is e. Tarai ki. Tarai ki. I think. Find out for sure. Let's do that instead. Tadaima. Tadaima. Just kidding. Where's Ma? How come? Oh, shit. 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 So the middle stroke. This is where I fucked up. The middle stroke on ki is like a tall 5 here. Let me switch to Japanese. My computer is fucking weird. I have to type in Chinese first before I can type in Chinese. So, there's ki right there. And now ma.
Oops. So there you have it. You see how I got the middle stroke confused. Tadaima. Tadaima. That's like what you say when you leave your house, right? Tadaima. Yeah, right there. Or when you come home. Excuse me, I got it backwards. I wonder if that shows up. Does that show up? The little switch thing? Let's look at the stream. Yeah, it does. Tadaima is from 1981. Who is it by? Akiko. Fucking $34. 93. Although... So is it from 81? LP album? Or is it from 93? I don't understand. Other versions. LP album. So I guess that's gonna be the first release. This is a CD release. Oh yeah, it says right there. If I'd fucking pay attention. Album reissue. So 81, actually. You were correct. I should really just save this so I don't have to set it up every single fucking time I get a new character. Although I only get a new character like once every month and a half. Tell it to change. Okay. Oh, the problem is now the color doesn't match. I wish the color could change with the picture. That'd be nice. So instead, let's just choose a more neutral color, so like a gray. Oh, there we go. Japan scares you? Why is that?
See forever.
Do you say only normies say that? We'll watch it all together. Oops, I don't need two slashes. Pun, 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 pun. Gotti, pum, you, pum, you.
Ano gol saten de, minna ga moshi skip wo shite, moshi ano machi no mannaka de, te wo tsunaide sora wo miagetara, moshi mo ano machi no doko ka de.
Yeah, the song is pretty funky, man. I dig it. I feel like this is Lady Gaga before Lady Gaga. At least, I assume this is before Lady Gaga because the quality is kind of low. Like, I feel like this is something Lady Gaga would do. That's the point that I'm trying to make. Whether it came before Lady Gaga or not. Pretty good song though. My email is open. So, anyways, what time is it? 12:38. I need to probably wrap up here soon. Because I still need to shower. I'm still in pajamas, and by pajamas I mean underwear. I still need to shower, and then
I mean, I still have time. It's not like I need to rush, so I don't want you guys to think I need to, like, rush out of here. I'm just saying, at some point soon, we need to wrap up, because it is, like, 30 minutes by train to the other school, where I will be going to teach English to some of the Japanese assistants at the school. Today is my day off, by the way. It's just that, if you didn't catch it earlier, I don't remember how early in the stream I mentioned this, it's sort of an exchange, a language exchange class, where the Japanese assistants will learn some English from me, and they'll teach me some Japanese. Although right now, I'm kind of just focusing on learning hiragana. I feel like learning to read the language will really open up the language a lot more to me. Although I'm a long ways away from being able to read kanji and katakana, but hiragana is a good start. Yeah, of course I'm still an English teacher. I actually like teaching English. I like my kids, man. The kids are fun. Because I never fucking grew up. I'm still a fucking irresponsible child. My favorite time at school is I already got this. Anyways, my favorite time is recess, because I'll fucking play with the kids so fucking much, fucking run around. Their favorite game is the monster. Their favorite game is the monster, where I am the monster and I am trying to eat them, and so they just run away from me. It's basically like tag, except without the actual tagging part. I just chase them, and then whenever I reach them, I just grab them, tickle them, throw them on the trampoline, and then chase another kid. And I have too much fun doing that. Yeah, I'm gonna learn katakana. Honestly, there's so many great fucking games here that just never fucking get released in America, or at least in English, that I feel like not only would learning to read the fucking language in general just open up the language to me a lot more, but also it would mean I can play some of these games. My students, yeah, actually, you're right, Lawlers. It's the school teaches, the main school itself teaches toddlers through kindergarten, although even after they graduate from kindergarten, they still have like afternoon classes. Oh, you know what? I stopped the music. Let's go back to music. So, let me set this up. Instead of photo, let's do image slideshow. Let's do like 25 seconds. Throw some shoujo ramune in there. Yes, actually. It depends on the school. It's part of their uniform. But whenever they leave, yes. Why did my music not start playing? What has happened here? There it is.
yeah, they have these, they have these ame. Oh god, don't get me started. It's too fucking cute, Jell-O. It's too fucking cute. I can't handle it. Anyways, yes, it's like for safety reasons, it makes them easier to see. The red backpacks thing, like the hats I think are the same for every school, maybe. I'm not 100% sure about that, but the backpacks, you know, it's whatever they fucking bring, right? The school that I will be working at, they provide the backpacks, so they're actually blue and yellow. I don't even know if Jell-O knows who the fuck Quill is. This is Quill, right here, in the background. That none of you fuckers have even bothered to read. No, fuck you guys. It's not finished yet. I had only provided some samples, really. I'm working with an artist right now to do some art for the book, but right now we're just working on character designs, and you half read the first fucking episode, dickhead. You didn't fucking read half the damn book. You read the first half of the fucking episode. If we go here, you may fucking notice something. You may notice that I have fucking 4 episodes right there. And here's the cover to the 5th one. Oh, I just realized I thought I was on monitor capture, and I'm not on monitor capture, so you didn't see what I just fucking did. But, I just highlighted four PDF files. And then I also have a PNG file for the cover of the 5th episode, because that's nearly finished. I would love to make it an anime, but I don't have the money or connections to get that set up. Also, it's probably too fucking garbage. People are gonna fucking read it and be like, "Nah, fuck this shit, this is fucking trash. Who the fuck wrote this? Some fucking faggot named Nolan Alighieri? Wait a minute. Isn't one of the fucking characters in the fucking show called, or in the book called Alighieri? Man, this is just some fucking insert fanfic. What a bunch of fucking trash." Hachiman Hikigaya. Let's look at this.
Where's Mal? There's Mal. Indeed. But Quill is supposed to be younger. According to Mal, Hachiman Hikigaya is 17. I don't actually know what Quill's age is. I never bothered to fucking specify that shit because it never felt important to the fucking story. What is important is that he is younger than that. That's all that's really important. You can fucking decide for yourselves how fucking old he is. Yeah, you can do that, you could say that, except that I'm pretty sure the fucking anime wouldn't be fucking popular. Not that you guys would know. You haven't fucking read the shit. Yeah, it's kind of similar. Oh, hey, that's that anime that someone recommended to me. I'm assuming it's Conrad who recommended to me before I left for China that I never actually watched. Conrad, just for you, I'd considered since during the time between hiring this artist and getting her to start work on this, I've actually moved to a better place and a better job. I now think it's possible for me to afford maybe doing some insert art for the book as well. I'm not saying I want to turn the whole damn thing into a fucking manga, but I considered maybe after getting all the characters designed and getting the proper cover done. I do have covers for the book right now, but they're all just like temporary mocked up designs I did by myself. So I considered now that I'm getting paid better, I might pay her to do some insert art, like, since I have it divided by episodes. Obviously when I actually release it, it's not gonna be divided into episodes, it will be just one solid book. But I still thought kind of preserving the idea of, like, blocks that are divided into multiple chapters, as it is now, and maybe having insert art for each episode. So, Conrad, you'd have some pictures to look at. It'd only be, I think there's gonna be 6 episodes total. In fact, actually, I know there's gonna be 6 episodes. That's just it. 6 is the last episode. I'm finishing up 5 right now, though. So there'd be 6 pieces of art to look at. And maybe just have her design one important moment in that episode. Sixteen. I don't know where you're pulling 16 from. I get what you're hinting at. I had considered maybe just kind of making some self-referential parody. Too fucking much. I doubt my artist would even want to. She's actually working on a visual novel. She had a Kickstarter
for a visual novel, and she's busy working on that. I'm just kind of like her fucking, whenever she's bored of working on that, she'll, you know, spend a few minutes on my own stuff. Let me open up Steam here, and I'll bring up her visual novel for you. It's been greenlit, but it's not been released yet. But you can still look at the information on it on Steam. So it went through Kickstarter, got funded for, I think, 11,000 Canadian dollars. And then... and then they went to Greenlight, and... Okay. Steam, go away. And then they went to Greenlight, and it actually went through Greenlight as well, so... Goodness. Will come up now. Community green light. I'm gonna bring it up first, and then I'll turn monitor capture back on. I know monitor capture is off. Here it is. Monitor capture. Where's my chat? So I can see what I've missed. This is her visual novel. Let's pause the music. I actually have never watched the full trailer.
Fukatsu, fish, soshite shiko. Boku wa hon ni kakomare, issho ni mawari wo watashite iru. Nigete iru no ka? Sore tomo nani ka wo sagashite iru no ka? 叫声が聞こえる。若い女性の甲高い悲鳴。目の隅から殺気に満ちた視線を捉える。僕は目を覚ます。
So, anyways, yeah, that's her project that she's been working on. I didn't realize she also wrote the story. She probably fucking read my shit and was like, God, this is fucking trash. I asked her to read it so she could at least understand the characters better. So anyways. That's that. So... she's so focused on doing that I'm pretty sure she has no fucking interest in doing a whole goddamn manga for me. It'd also have to be extremely fucking condensed, because I'm pretty sure she would not want to do, like, between the 6 light novel episodes, that would have to be broken down into, like, 12 fucking volumes of manga. And I'm pretty sure she definitely wouldn't want to do that. And I don't have the money to pay for that. Anyways, back to the music. Sorry. Did I just push stop or did I push play? Fucking play. So. So anyways, yeah. Yeah, that's that. I have, Conrad...
I didn't think of making any H series out of
out of this, but I did have plans of, I know, like 700, oh, 7,000, yeah, maybe somewhere around there, actually. I think it depends. It's not like I fucking asked her, because it's just never anything I fucking cared about asking her, because I didn't want to. Why would I ask her? I wouldn't ask her to do that. That's not my focus here. My focus is fucking writing my fucking story. So I don't know how much she would charge for it, if she would even do it, which I'm pretty sure she wouldn't fucking do it. Anyways, going back to what Lawlers was saying about a 0.5 episode, although I'm not sure where you pulled the 16 out of, there's 6, not 16 episodes. I had considered actually doing some sort of self-referential parody, because, you know, there, obviously none of you have fucking read it, so I don't know why it fucking matters, but, the story starts up pretty lighthearted, but then it kind of gets a little too serious, and if anything, I don't want to change that, but at the same time, I kind of hate that, because I had originally started writing this because I always feel like there's too many sci-fi shows in general that maybe take themselves too seriously, when I think fucking, like, kick-ass giant robots should be, like, fun and cool and not serious. So I kind of hated the fact that I originally started this to not be a very serious story, and it wound up becoming pretty fucking serious in the end, so I thought about maybe kind of relieving that with, like, my own fucking slice of life, I guess you would say. Oh. I don't know what 16.5 is in Sword Art, because Sword Art's fucking garbage. right now, nowhere. You just have to wait until it's finished. I think the writing part will be done in about 6 months. The writing part will be done in about 6 months. That does not necessarily mean it will be released in 6 months. I am still wrapping up the end. Oh, is that the... No, okay, never mind. I don't know. Yeah, I don't know what 16.5 is. Maybe one of you dickheads should stop talking about it and tell me what the fuck 16.5 is, shitheads. Don't make me fucking Google this shit. Chapter 16.5 of the novel, really written by the author, and the fanfic titles are not supposed to be long.
That seems... I really don't like the guy who fucking did Sword Art. He has, like, no fucking self-restraint, and he's just the most... There's, like, specific words I'm looking for, and they're not coming to mind right now, but... If he actually wrote 16.5 as a fanfic for his own work, that's just... Ugh. Okay, yeah, well, I fucking gathered by your fucking subtle hints that it's fucking has hentai, but that doesn't tell me a lot. I can fucking say Chocolate Cube is a fucking doujin of Rabbit Show, but that doesn't explain why it's so fucking disturbing. So, I mean, if it's just them having sex, I don't get it. But that's because it creates... Okay, first of all, I'm not saying there's anything wrong with that. He's not doing it himself, right? It's not self-indulgent, right? So... I personally wouldn't, like, here's my mindset, right? God forbid, should my fucking writing actually get that popular? I don't expect it to, but I have zero fucking problem of people going out creating fucking fanfics and just, you know, having my characters do the nastiest fucking shit to each other. In fact, I would encourage it. It would make me feel good that people care that much about my shit that they want to see my characters do these kind of sadistic things to each other. Although maybe I say sadistic, which kind of then implies something violent. I don't know about that. That might be done out of hatred towards my content. They wanted to see... Anyways, let's not fucking nuance. Anyways. Let's not get into semantics here. Wait, 2 years worth of... Jesus Christ. I have some porn. It's like that. The... Man who hadn't come in 12 years. And it just sprays like a fountain. I'm not drawing it, and I'm pretty sure my artist has no interest in drawing that either, but you're welcome to, if you want to put the effort into it. The blue-haired girl.
Conrad, get on it. You hear it, you have fans waiting. You want to see the original concept art for Lily? Let's put that on the screen. Actually, hang on. Let's see, where is it? Here it is. I said fit to screen. How the fuck is that not fit to screen? There we go. Copyright Conrad 2015. Original concept art for fucking Lily. Bounty Hunter Space Pirate Lily.
Where the fuck did my other slipper go? Why do I only have one slipper? There it is.
One foot is really cold, the other one is nice and warm. Kilogram sword, the dragon destroyer. I have to say, this is like by far my fucking most favorite art I've ever seen. Conrad, the almighty Con in chat. This is before I had hired my artist. He decided he wanted to do the concept art for my character, Lily. And this is his fucking genius. Genius here. The only thing that I think it's missing that I think Valentino wins over Conrad is the switch pictures, damn it. Go to the next photo in the slideshow, damn it. Okay, the only thing I think Valentina's design wins over Conrad's are the sleeping eyes on the eye mask. When she fucking did that, I was like, that is the most fucking adorable thing ever. I fucking love it. Fucking would. I guess we should talk about that. I know Conrad knows this, but my fucking story, I didn't even mean for this to happen. Like, I'd watched Outlaw Star way back when it was like airing on Toonami when I was a kid, and you know, I hadn't watched it pretty much since then. I remember liking the show a lot, but since then I had actually started writing my own story about you know, this female android found in a box by a red-haired, cocky, womanizing guy and this confident kid. As they journey to find the Everstream. And then I rewatched Outlaw Star for the first time in years, and I was like,
Well, damn it. My story is the most unoriginal fucking piece of shit ever because this story was done back in the fucking 90s. By an anime that is... By an anime that is just much fucking better. So much more fucking superior. So, you know, if you guys have been itching for Outlaw Star, but have watched Outlaw Star too many times, then, just fucking look forward to my fucking story where it's just Outlaw Star, but with different character names. Yep, there you go. If you want to watch my, if you want to watch my book, then, just go watch Outlaw Star. Anyways, there might be some fucking bebop influence on my work as well, but I think I'm pretty aware of that. Actually, not, you know, I don't think there's that much bebop influence in my work. Not intentional, at least. Just like, then again, just like with Outlaw Star, there was, I did not intentionally just say, boy, I like Outlaw Star so much, I just want to write this story. That's not what I intended to do. I will be honest, though. It is not exactly. See you later, faggot. I was gonna download Warframe, but then I decided to get Overwatch instead. Anyways, there was no intention to copy Outlaw Star. I didn't just sit down and be like, boy, I love this anime a lot, I just want to write this anime. That was not the hope. It just kind of happened. I did want to change, I know you guys can't see this because I don't have monitor capture open right now, but just take my word, I designed a pen name, I guess you'd say, for myself, for my book, and I actually don't really like it too much. I want to change that. I guess I have time to change it. I actually wanted to change it to Ribbon. I actually liked that. I thought that worked really well. But the problem is that the subtitle for Everstream is Dot Ribbon. So, I don't know. That, again, feels like self-indulgent, masturbatory self-insert fanfic. By calling your own fucking pen name the same as your fucking book.
Meditation. Livestream01.ribbon.
Anyways.
You guys have gotten kind of quiet. I think mostly it's just Conrad who's talking, with occasionally Grass and Jello jumping in just to say a word or two. But we're back at the beginning of the album here, and it is 1:20. I need to shower and clean up a little bit before I hop on the train to go to Fukushima. Not the Fukushima that had the nuclear power plant explosion. A different Fukushima. I need to go to Fukushima so I can go teach some English to some adults. No? You can't add anything. Not on my actual novel. If you want to fucking do some fanfic, feel free to. Some more streaming later. I don't know if I'll stream tonight. My next day off is Sunday, so maybe Saturday night or Sunday morning. No, well, Sunday morning I want to actually talk to my mom. So, because Sundays are my days to talk to my mommy. So, probably Saturday night. I'll stream, so that probably won't work for you, Conrad, or Lawlers, even though he's not here anymore, but, yep. So,
just look forward to that if you're available. If not, then fuck you.
So, I'm gonna wait 10 seconds to make sure I don't just cut the stream off in the middle while we're waiting for the chat delay to catch up.